Okay, so Gemma 2 is out, and we've two flavors of it. We've got a 9 billion model and a 27 billion model. In this video, I'm going to go through some examples of it. I'm going to tell you just briefly a little bit about it and show you where you can get started to actually use this as well. There are two sizes of this, both the 9 billion parameter version and the 27 billion parameter version. The 9 billion parameter version is actually outperforming Llama 3 8 billion for quite a number of benchmarks. And also, I must admit, when I use it, I find this model seems to be certainly on par with Llama 3 and seems to be doing better for certain things as well in there. So that gives us another sort of stock model that's really useful, not too big, but able to do very well. The 27 billion parameter model, Google is claiming that this model can be competitive with models that are sort of 70 billion parameters. In fact, I'll show you something in the technical report that sort of confirms that with the LLMsys chatbot Arena in there. So how to run this model? If you want to run this model, you're going to, for this 27 billion model, you're going to need to have either an NVIDIA H100. So it's been designed to just fit nicely on H100 or an A100 that has 80 gig of VRAM there, or it'll fit on a TPU as well. The actual 9 billion one, though, seems to fit nicely onto much smaller GPUs. So I've been using it on an L4. I think it will fit on a T4 as well. So you can certainly try that out there. So we can see that when we look at the benchmarks for this, the 9 billion is very competitive against the Llama 3 in here for the Llama 3 8 billion. The 27 billion is certainly getting up there towards the 70 billion Llama 3 model. We're talking about something that's less than half the size of this. So it's certainly not surpassing the benchmarks of Llama 3 70B on all of them, etc. It is clearly doing a lot better than models like Grok 1, which I've talked about in the past as being an irrelevant model. It's so big, and the performance is not good enough that really justifies anyone trying to run it or trying to fine-tune it, etc. Total opposite to Gemma 2 here. So just quickly before we go into the tech report, we can see that this has basically got a commercial license. You can use this for a variety of different things, and the Gemma license is there. You can go through and look at this. I've talked about deploying it, setting this up, I think, to next month being able to just deploy this on Google Cloud with one click and be able to run it on Vertex AI as well in there. Another interesting side fact in here is that they talk about they're actively working on open sourcing some of the text watermarking technology, which is really interesting to see as well. All right, let's jump into the tech report and have a look. So in the tech report, we can see a little bit about that they've added some new things to the architecture, or they've changed the attention in here, which is interesting. We know from some things in here that, like, the 9 billion model, people complained about the 7 billion model not being called an 8 billion model. Because of the tokenizer in here, whatever the models are, the embedding parameters end up being quite big here. And this is just due to that the tokenizer has 256,000 tokens in it, as opposed to much smaller tokenizers like the Mistral 32,000 tokenizer, etc. And I'll have a quick look at that later on so we can compare some of the things even to Llama 3 in there. So we can see that the 9 billion one was actually trained on the TPU-4s, whereas the 27 billion one has been trained on the more recent TPU-5s. Surprisingly, though, neither of these have been trained on TPU-6s, which perhaps suggests that there's not a lot of those around, even inside Google at the moment. So when we look at the training data, we can see that the 27 billion parameter model has been trained on 13 trillion tokens. So I think that's a little bit less than Llama 3 from memory. And the 9 billion parameter model has been trained on 8 trillion tokens. And I must say that when we look at it, I'm very impressed that the 9 billion model is doing so well in here. In some of my tests, I found that the multilingual side of some of these models definitely is better than some of the things out there. A lot of that's due to the tokenizer, which at the end we can go through and have a look at this. Okay, so when we look at the post-training here, we can see that there's not a huge amount that's a surprise. And we've got supervised fine-tuning based on English. We've also got some clear uses of synthetic data in here as well with the SFT. But the other thing that's interesting is this whole model merging bit, is that they've actually done mergers of the models based on different hyperparameters and based on different things that were there. So when we look at the full benchmarks, we can see that certainly these models are doing, that the smaller 9 billion model is very competitive, beating out, I think, almost all the time, Llama 3, 8 billion. And we can see that they've left out the Llama 3, 70 billion, because I think that actually beats the 27 billion one, which is to be expected based on the fact that it's twice the size in there. One of the other things that's really interesting in here is they've been testing these models out on Chatbot Arena there. And they've actually found that on Chatbot Arena, based on the LMSys website, they're finding that preliminary results show that Gemma 27 billion sets a new state of the art for open weights models, surpassing the Llama 3 70 billion instruct and the Nemotron instruct models that are in. That's very interesting. For a long time, I felt that these benchmarks don't always show how great a model is. And I've talked about in videos multiple times that internally at Google and at other places, these benchmarks are really only used for showing to the public that internally they've got their own benchmarks that they're testing each model on and stuff like that. The best one that we get to see is often this LMSys Chatbot Arena. So it's very interesting to see that they're claiming that the Gemma 27 billion model is performing so strongly there. All right, let's jump into the code and have a look at some of the outputs from the model and see how they are. Okay, so let's jump in and have a look at some of the outputs from the Gemma 2 9 billion model. So I've got it set up in this notebook with the Hugging Face transformers. I'll probably make a couple of changes before I put this up. So this may be a little bit later than the video going up, but I'll certainly put it up in the description as soon as I can. So if we look at the outputs that we're getting, we've definitely got this sort of continuation that we saw with Gemma, where we've got the sort of high quality chain of thought stuff, or this very step-by-step kind of thing with markdown, with clearly explaining stuff. And we see that sort of throughout all the different outputs. In some ways, it's probably a lot more detailed than what we saw with the Gemma 1 models, etc., that were in there. Interestingly, questions like this about the Vicuna and stuff like that, when I was testing a version just in PyTorch, it actually came up with some really interesting results out, where when I asked this exact same question, it basically seemed to understand that, okay, this might not be actually about llamas or alpacas because of the way I spelt llamas, and that it's probably about language models. So it came back, well, it seems you're curious about a family tree of large language models. And then it went through and actually gave some stats out about what the difference between llama and alpaca and vicuna models were looking at this. So that doesn't seem to happen all the time. It certainly happened in my early testing with the straight PyTorch versions before the Transformers version was working. We do see it very consistently using this kind of markdown chain of thought when we ask for it in here. Even when we ask for the email and we ask it, getting it to basically give the chain of thought out, it puts this whole thing into sort of like a step-by-step kind of thing. When we ask it to do the young child one, it does a decent job of doing this. Now, interestingly, when we compare this to the 27 billion model, I'll just skip back and forth a little bit. You will see on the 27 billion model that you can get much more in-depth answers back. So here's the 27 billion model. You can see that when it's actually supposed to be taking on the personality of Freddy, the five-year-old, it actually uses emojis and stuff quite a bit more. That I didn't really see emojis coming out in the 9 billion model that much. Maybe I'm sure if you prompt for it, you'll probably get it. But in this one, we can see quite a funny little email with emojis, with things like this. And this is representative of the 27 billion model. The 27 billion model is not easy to run, though. I'm not running a quantized version. I'm sure quantized versions will be out probably later this week that you'll be able to try out and stuff like that with this. If we look at, again, just re-emphasizing that, the whole sort of thing of, if we look at the letter from the vice president, that's the 9 billion version. If we look at the 27 billion version, we can see that, okay, we've got something that's longer, sort of a bit more maybe up to date, like that it's mentioning certain things and stuff like that. It's interesting that it knows that it's Kamala Harris, even though I never told it that. And in fact, the 9 billion version, does better predicting from Kate, the vice president here. So this is like the system prompt passing in here, whereas the 27 has gone out on its own and signed it from the real person and not Kate in this example. Another fun one is that one of the good things is this model can be succinct and to the point. And this one, we ask it for the capital of London. We ask it to be short and succinct. And sure enough, it gives us London and it gives us a little flag in there. Whereas in the 9 billion one, we just get London twice out of that. So that was experimenting with that. Questions like the Geoffrey Hinton stuff has no problems with those. If anything, the chain of thought in these is actually much more to the point and not going on as much as many other models do for that. And in contrast to that, I would say one of the strengths of these models is the whole area of creative writing. The creative writing examples that I've put out have really been quite amazing at some of them, at like how good some of them are. And this is both true for the 9 billion one as well as the 27 billion one in here. Code stuff, it's on par for that. GSM 8K, we're getting the chain of thought being much more to the point. We're getting questions like this. Sometimes it will get it right. Often it will not get it right. This one that's actually quite hard at the end, though, it did get right all of the times in here, both for the word version and the actual math version. If we look at the 27 billion model, we've got a little bit longer on reasoning in the step-by-step stuff out here. And it seems to be able to do this, get this right each time it does it. That said, I wouldn't say currently this model is great at GSM 8K. It seems like it's a bit hit and miss for testing these out. My guess is over time, we will see how well it does with these. So doing some tests earlier in the week with things like this, write a poem about artificial intelligence, where the first letter of each line spells out singularity. It seemed to do really well at this kind of stuff. Another one that was really interesting is write a critical analysis of your own abilities, limitations, potential biases as an AI language model. So these are some red teaming kind of things. And it's interesting that it does seem to know that it's a Gemma model. So you can see the result that it comes back is as a Gemma open weights AI assistant, I possess several capabilities that allow me to be a useful tool. And then it can also talk about some of the limitations of it going through this as well. Again, a lot of it seems to be down to the how you prompt it. By trying to prompt it different ways, you can actually get very different styles of answers out of this. So here you can see that when we just ask it, can it have a question without give rationale? When we ask for rationale, it gives a very clear markdown for that. But here when you see it says one could imagine creative ways to bridge the gap. So this, when we don't ask for the chain of thought, it tends to be perhaps a little bit more creative in its outputs. Not necessarily always like it as in hallucinations, but it seems to be not constrained in the same way. And my guess is that's due to the instruction tuning, with a lot of the instruction tuning examples being asking for specific chain of thought kind of things in here. Anyway, the React stuff, it does quite well. The other ones, it does quite well as well. Okay, so just to finish up, I would say that there's some other releases out from Google today. On AI Studio, you will be able to find the new Gemini 1.5 Pro with 2 million context windows. So can you start using that now? There's also some code execution stuff up there. And the other thing that I wanted to just show you quickly is that Gemma 2, 27 billion is actually up there. If you want to come in here and actually test out the model, you can actually come in here and start trying it out straight away and see that the 27 billion model, what it's like, what it can do, so that you get a sense of if you want to run this locally later on or something like that, you can. But if you want to use it just purely to test it out and stuff like that, you can do that on AI Studio right now. So anyway, as always, if you've got any questions or comments, please put them in the comments below. If you found the video useful, please click like and subscribe. And I will talk to you in the next video. Bye for now.